Let's make homemade mozzarella. To learn more about the science, check out our other video. For ingredients, you'll need citric acid, rennet, and non-homogenized milk. You can find citric acid and non-homogenized milk in the grocery store. However, most milk is homogenized, so you need to look carefully. We found ours at Whole Foods. We bought the rennet online at Amazon and have it linked below. For equipment, you'll need a slotted spoon, spatula, a whisk, a thermometer, that's a must here, a medium pot and strainer, and dish gloves. A digital measuring scale isn't necessary, but helpful. In one bowl, add citric acid and water and stir vigorously. In another small bowl, add the rennet and water and also stir that vigorously. Then pour 1/2 gallon of milk into the pot, add in the citric acid while whisking vigorously, and bring up the heat to 90 degrees Fahrenheit over low medium heat. Once the milk is at 90 degrees, add in the rennet while stirring with your spatula, not a whisk. Stir for a full 25 seconds, put it on a timer, and then cover and let it sit for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, you should see curds, and it's the most exciting thing ever. Using a large knife, cut the curds into a grid pattern like this. Place the pot back on the heat and continue to heat it to 105 degrees Fahrenheit while stirring occasionally and very gently so to not break up the curd too much. Then remove the pot from the heat and let it sit for another 5 minutes uncovered. Then strain the curds by gently removing them with a slotted spoon and placing it in a strainer. Let the curds sit and drain for 10 minutes. Meanwhile, add 1 tablespoon of salt to the whey liquid and place that pot back on the stove and heat it to 180 degrees Fahrenheit. It's going to be quite hot. That's why you have the dish gloves. Pour some of that over the curds, enough to cover the curds, and let it sit for 15 to 20 seconds. Then, with your dish gloves to protect your hands, begin to stretch the mozzarella. Bring up the mozzarella and let gravity do the work. And gently fold and stretch like you see here, just for about 6 to 7 folds. At first, it won't look like it's doing very much, and then all of a sudden, you'll have this stretchy, shiny, beautiful mozzarella within seconds. It's definitely the coolest part of this. Store the mozzarella in water until you're ready to eat. We recommend having this within the first day or two for maximum freshness. And any way you decide to eat it, it's going to be delicious. Although we recommend going with a classic caprese salad. Be sure to like and subscribe for more videos. Thanks for watching.